What's happening? This is Lightning Bolt Forever, finally back with more Duke Nukem 3D 20th Anniversary World Tour. Yeah, it's been a little while, but yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get right back into this. So when we last left off, throat's killing me. When we last left off, we defeated the Cycloid Emperor at the stadium, and Duke enjoyed a little bit of R&R at the end there, and well, yeah, all seemed well until we discovered that the aliens were not finished with their invasion. So, we're going to go ahead and fire this thing up here. We're going to be starting episode 4, The Birth, which was released at the end of the same year that the original 3 episodes were released. So we'll go ahead and get started here from the beginning, just like all the others, 100% secrets on Come Get Some.
Come Get Some.
Duke, we've got a new problem here. This video was shot by an undercover operative.
I'm going in. Somebody's gonna friggin' pay for screwing up my vacation.
Alright, so immediately starting off here, we're thrown into the middle of a thunderstorm here, with lightning coming down and turrets firing at us straight away. Yeah, this is a pretty difficult start here, and well, yeah, it can wreck you if you're not if you're not ready for it, I guess. But anyway, come over here, hit this handprint, then jump up onto this ledge and run over here for our first secret with some pipe bombs. Hitting the handprint opens up secret number 2 with this cave in here, night vision goggles and atomic health. But anyway, yeah, this is episode 4, level 1. It's impossible, and So yeah, what was going on in that video clip we saw? Well, you'll see what those alien creatures were at the end of this level, in fact. So anyway, yeah, we'll head into the improbable mission facility now. Which, yes, if this level doesn't already scream Mission Impossible, then, you know, I don't know. You know, I mean, there's just like an absurd number of references. Like, we have the IMF here, we have We have the music in the background, just like, you know, all these things that just scream Mission Impossible. Even this right here.
This tape will self-destruct in 1 second.
Yep. Watch out for that. Anyway, let's chuck a pipe bomb over there because we got a crack in the wall, and we can get 3 large med kits, 90% health. So yeah. First things first, we'll head into the briefing room. That guy usually jumps out from behind that corner, but obviously, because I'm recording, he doesn't want to now, but that's okay. Alright, took care of everybody. Pipe bombs, get some health and ammo up here. Anyway, the reason I was trying to... Whoa! Die. The reason I was trying to get back here was because there's a shotgun back here, as you just saw. But, yeah, obviously he didn't want to cooperate, so... Let's clear out this room real fast with these enforcers. Should be one more guy... Die. There we go. Alright, so, yeah, we'll go through that door in a bit. What's on the screen here? Your mission, destroy! Alright, so we'll be off now, and, well, yeah. We can grab some health in here. I didn't want to take 2 of them, but that's okay. Anyway, we'll head down the hallway. Get rid of the troopers that plague the facility. Get rid of all of them. We'll come back to these switches later, because we'll actually need the blue key further on in that room. But anyway, right now we will head into the mess hall. Get rid of him. Pick these guys off here like shooting fish in a barrel. And these guys. Die, you. Alright, it's the end of everyone in here. But, anyway, oh, yes, let's flip the lights on first. You can open this wall, and it just takes you back to the beginning of the level. But yet, do you see... Oh, wow. You see how, like, difficult this level is already? I mean, this level really doesn't play around when it comes to enemy placement and things. Anyway, let's grab atomic health, some more ammo if we need it. We'll open up the walk-in freezer here. Get rid of him. We have the freeze thrower, speaking of freezing, and we'll kick this carcass out of the way. You can climb through these vents here, but I'm not going to go in there because there's some octobrains in there, and we don't want to face them yet. But anyway, hit this for another secret back here. We get the shrinker, slash expander, and we pop up through here, through the kitchen sink, and we'll just head on out this way here. Let's see where that octobrain went. Oh, it sounds like he's up in the vents. Whoa! Hello there, buddy boy. Whoa! Get out of here. Alright, and there should be, yes, chain gun. And, hey, buddy. Get a surprise attack on this guy. We have the blue key here. We can hit the hand dryer here, jump up for another secret. And now we can leave the bathroom. And yeah, this will take us into the next room here. Not gonna go that way, though, because I find that it's easier to handle the barracks like this. Toss a pipe bomb, wait for him to gather up a little bit. Ooh, that was a bad toss. And just blow him up. If, you know, they decide to blow up. Come on. Alright. That did not go by too terribly bad. Yeah, that just goes back to the bathroom. Let's see. Yes, what do we have on the television here? Yes, the forecast for today. Thunderstorm warning has been issued. Alright. So, this bed here, if you, activate it. Yeah, it actually works like an elevator. You can come in here for another secret, jetpack, and devastator ammo, which is secret number 5, by the way. We can head out of here finally, hit the right and center switches. We can take out all these guys here. Get rid of you and you guys. Whoa! Easy there, trigger. Get these. You can open up the command center window here. And then these guys in here, there's a commander in there, so we'll have to get him down. Use the shrinker on... Whoa! You're not a commander. There you are. Get rid of him like that with the shrinker. We have the red key, and shrink him down to size. Step on him like that. Alrighty. So, yes. Got some famous presidents here. We got Lincoln, Jackson, Washington... let's see. I can hit this computer here. This opens up another secret with an RPG inside. RPG! And yeah, you can get back into this room with the jetpack from that way. Anywho, let's... yes, we have everything in here. So let's hit the left and right switches. Head through this way. And yes, now we're back in the briefing room again. And yeah, we're still... We're not going to take that elevator down. Steed. But instead, we're going to go this way. Down this hallway here, and yes, open up this door. We got sentry drones. Yes, first sentry drones of the episode. Whoa. And one more. Whoa! Oh man, I was trying to get through that without getting blown up there. Anyway, RPG ammo on the subway parts box, laser trip bombs. Yes. What else have we in here? We can jump over here this way. Let's see, from Wars of the World, Prop Department, to O. Wells. Mr. Orson Welles, and you can open this box up and grab some health. And at long last, we have expander ammo, finally. So yes, the expander, like I said, way back when, was introduced in this episode. So now we have ammo for it, and we can just blow this up here. Watch a nice little light show there. Now, you have to be very careful in here. When you fall down... Catch yourself with the jetpack, and then hit this button. Then hit the second and fourth buttons. And then you can drop down right here and open the lock. Now, if you touch the floor, or the ceiling for that matter, you, well, yeah, you'll get a nasty trap that we're not ready to deal with quite yet. So let's close that off. Get this wall to open. Whoa! Did nothing. Die. There we go. Alright, get all them down, hit that switch, we can get rid of this big cop here. And now, here's the trap I was talking about. Yeah, it's a lot of guys to deal with, especially if you're surrounded on all four sides. So, yeah, make sure that you have the jetpack when you come in here, because if not, you... the odds of surviving this are pretty slim. But anyway, let's go ahead and head on through here, the whole get smart operation here with all the doors opening. And right in here, this is our, takes us to our last secret. Nice. Takes us to our last secret. We can get rid of him. Grab a pipe bomb there. We can flip this, and that opens up this little train car here. We can get some items in. Now, we'll go ahead and open up this door here. Ooh, nice. And, whoa! Use the shrinker on these guys. And now, the expander. This is how it works. Yep, it just, it blows the enemies up and then eventually causes them to explode. But anyway, yeah, we get the Devastator out of there. And that's all 7 secrets, so we can, yes, the man from UNCLE. But anyway, we can head on down here, take the elevator. We have a pipe bomb right here with a crack in the door. So if we shoot the pipe bomb... What is that thing back there? Whoa, that was a bit freaky. Let's, go back here, get rid of these guys. So, yeah, let's head back this way, and... Whoa! Now these things here... These things are what we saw in that video. These are called protector drones, and they have the power to shrink you by spitting, Basically, like, they're a moving shrink ray. They can basically spit, like, a venom at you to shrink you down. And, well, yeah, they can just claw you in the face at close range, but... Yeah. Needless to say, because they can shrink you, the shrinker does not work on them. But, yeah, just be careful with them. But anyway, that's the first level of episode 4 done. So when we come back, I will see you in... Let's rock. We're gonna rock here. I will see you in episode 4, level 2, Duke Burger. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and we'll be back finally with more Duke 3D 20th Anniversary World Tour.